In the land of KP, on top of the hill, there was a small school that stood silent and still. The students were bored and without spirit. The teachers were unhappy, and I think one was bearded. No laughter in the hallways, no hope in their heart. The students were quiet to the end from the start. They needed adventure, some place fun to go, but where was that place? No one did know. Starting, it all began with our friend Mr. Martin. In a dark classroom where they were learning some math, Mr. Martin's bag started dancing like it was caught in a draft.
Whose bag is that?
That's Mr. Martin's bag.
The bag once opened was bursting with light. The teacher looked inside, although filled with fright.
Should the end go free? It's up to him, I Today we are going to read Call of the Wolves by Melvin Bergen. Okay, let's read the table of contents together. Contents. Introduction to Wolves, page 1. Gray wolf species, page 2. Family structure, page 4. How wolves hunt, page 8. How wolves communicate, page 12. Saving the wolves, page 14.
They were off, and the quaffle is taken immediately by Angelina Johnson of Gryffindor. What an excellent chaser that girl is, and rather attractive, too. Quaffle taken by Slytherin. There's Adrian speeding off toward the goalpost, but he's blocked by a second bludger, sent this way by Fred or George Weasley, I can't tell which. Nice play by Gryffindor beater. Anyway, and Johnson back in possession of the quaffle, a clear field ahead and off she goes. She's really flying. Dodges a speeding bludger. The goalposts are ahead. Come on now, Angelina. Keeper dives. Misses. Gryffindor scores! Yeah! Well, let's take it from there. I think we should go outside and play some Quidditch.
Wait, what the heck?
Ready?
I have no idea.
Wait, yes. Quidditch focus!
Today, Miss Sarah and I are going to be speaking about genre, and genre is...
My favorite genre is action.
I like science fiction.
I really like horror. It makes me scared.
I like fantasy.
I like mysteries and I love top guys.
I like superheroes.
My favorite genre is a mystery to find a killer.
My books are scary about vampires.
Okay, class, today we're going to learn about idioms. Can you say that word, idioms?
Idioms!
Okay, has anyone ever heard of idioms before? Matthew, what do you know about idioms?
I know that they're not the word.
Christian, that's
a type of phrase.
And now your host, Madman Isaac and Cool Kitty.
Hello! Welcome to idiomsonthebomb.com! And this is my blonde-haired co-host, the wonderful, the beautiful, not Catherine! And today we are going to be talking about idioms.
We're talking about idioms.
No, idioms, you idiot. An idiom is a phrase whose meaning is not what it says. That's what you wrote.
Yeah.
Did you see that girl fart? It sounded so nasty.
Did it sound like this?
Yo, time you got. Get up, Malay.
Oh no. Dang, I'm against the clock.
Can we try this?
Yep, that would be an arm and a leg.
Here's an arm.
And a leg.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Can I buy this?
Yes, that would cost all the money you have.
Make it rain.
Good day.
Thank you.
All right, ladies and gents. So after we've looked at all these elements of fairy tales, and we've kind of come up with this nice little list of resisms, as you will, we kind of would like to apply these in what we call a fractured fairy tale.
One time, back the bush.
Hey there lived
three little Indians, all named Victor.
I'm Victor. I'm Victor.
One day, the little Indians decide to leave their parents' house and make new houses of their own. The first little Indian built his house out of hay. The second little Indian built his house out of deer hide. The third little Indian built a longhouse located inside a palisade.
I love the smell of fresh.
Hey Victor, how about some of that fried bread over there?
Heck no, this is my gun. Go get your own.
Where?
Over
there. Oh, that's too far. Give me some of yours, that's being too cheap. No! No!
Jesus. Bread. The wolf sent this. No.
I want some fried bread!
Finally, they went to their brother's house that made the long house. They sat and talked. They made a plan.
Hey, Victor, can I have some fried bread?
Why should we give you some of our fervor if you beat down our houses?
Because you're supposed to help all your elders.
You're not an elder, you only live with you 2 days older than us.
Hey, I just wanted to bring you guys some sugar.
Get out of here, why would you leave an idea after all you did to us?
Jeez, come on, can you just help me?
This is the best thing, best friend for the stand up on race. You wouldn't be able to write this anyhow.
I promise not to be there for the house. I just wanted to take it to change your
mind. He's got the same money as me. What did you get?
This is all perfect for it. What's your friend?
The boys sang a thank you song to the creator and to the wolf for bringing the cheese. The wolf was happy that he got some fried bread, and all of them started to dance together.
As they lived richly ever after.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we've been talking a lot about fairy tales recently, and in those fairy tales, we've been talking about the connotations of various images,
the themes present in the text and the morals that we can learn. But now what I want us to do is take a fairy tale and we are going to flip it and make it a res tale.
Mirror, mirror on the ground, which one of us is really brown?
Sure ain't you. You're lighter than a ghost.
What?
The classic tale of Snow White has been plucked, knocked down, and stomped on. It ain't no joke. I like to buy the world. Yellow Snow might not have been the fairest, but she was for sure the brownest.
Hey!
Settle down. The Wicked Witch wanted that title for herself.
No.
Call me on Browner.
No.
I'm Bush Kid.
I'm Birdie.
I'm Dirt Kid.
I'm Mish.
I'm Stink Man.
Res Bomb.
Shorty.
Cousins, I need your help.
What's in it for us?
You gotta do the dishes, clean our house.
How about I tell Auntie how her Res Bomb got dented?
Tell me I'm not brown. Oh dearie, would you like some of my poison, corn soup?
I know someone's trying to kill me, but you look trustworthy.
Hey, Braddy.
Huh?
I think there's something wrong with Snow.
What do you mean?
Hey, Victor! We need your help!
Now that you gave enough answer, you go pick your own switch.
And whip them once.
Ow! Never mind, I'm up.
Romantic tale of love.
Ever sick, you guys are cousins.
Wasn't that awesome?
Yeah!
The halls were now happy and filled with joy, from the biggest girl to the smallest boy. And so that was it. That's all it took. Adventure came out of a book. And where did it begin? Where was the starting? I remember it was with our good friend, Mr. Martin.